It's difficult to watch the news, read a paper, or listen to a family meeting without word of the COVID-19 vaccine. While the focus is mostly on when we'll all get one, it's always helpful to go back to the basics about vaccines and understand a bit more about how they actually work.
You're so right, Nyari. Vaccines have been around for years. The first official vaccine, which was for smallpox, was developed way back in the 18th century. And anecdotally, early immunization scientists based in China would allegedly take smallpox scabs, crush them into a powder, and blow them up your nostril in an attempt to gain immunity. At least they had the right idea.
Indeed. But since then, it's not been only the vaccine technology that's improved, but also the health of the world. Vaccines have had an impressive run of success, being able to control and in most cases completely eliminate highly contagious and deadly diseases such as polio, measles, mumps and rubella.
While some diseases come and go, the more we learn about COVID-19, the more it becomes clear that it's showing no signs of disappearing anytime soon. A vaccine has therefore become an almost exclusive solution, first to protect those most at risk, and second to create a situation of overall immunity.
To understand how vaccines, and in this case the COVID-19 one, works, it helps to first look at how our bodies fight illness. When germs, such as viruses that cause the COVID-19, invade our bodies, they attack and multiply.
Now, our immune system has several tools up its sleeve to fight off infection. One of the most critical ones is its army of white blood cells. Yes, an army. These can swallow up and digest germs, produce antibodies that attack any piece of the virus left behind, and keep a log of what viruses were encountered previously and how they were defeated.
The first time a person is infected with the virus that causes COVID-19, it can take several days or weeks for their body to make and use all the germ-fighting tools that are needed to get over the infection. After the infection, the person's immune system remembers what it learned about how to protect the body against the disease in the future.
Yeah, amazing human bodies. Now, a vaccine does all of that without you needing to get the virus in the first place. Different types of vaccines work in different ways to offer protection, but with all types of vaccines, your body is left with a supply of memory cells, or T lymphocytes, that remember how to fight that specific virus in the future, and so provide you with immunity.
There are three main reasons South Africa opted for the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. First, unlike the AstraZeneca vaccines, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine has proved that it can work against the new COVID-19 variant that was first discovered in South Africa.
It's been tested in more than 44,000 patients, including 7,000 South Africans, our own people, and shown to be 85% effective against severe COVID-19 disease and 100% effective against death. Let me say that again, 100% effective against death.
Second, it's a single dose. This is obviously preferable, not only because it saves money, but also because it saves infrastructure and, most importantly, time.
And finally, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is made from a weakened adenovirus. That makes it very robust and tough because the tough protein coat of the adenovirus helps protect the genetic material inside. And it's for that reason that the Johnson & Johnson vaccines don't need to be stored at minus 70 degrees. Your average kitchen variety fridge will do the trick. Some more great news in our effort to fight COVID-19 was the arrival of the first batch of Pfizer vaccines in early May. And you're probably wondering how the Pfizer vaccine stacks up against the Johnson & Johnson one. Pretty well. While it's tricky to compare the vaccines side by side, which is a bit like comparing apples and oranges, the reality is that all of the COVID-19 vaccines that have been developed are really good, amazing even, at protecting your and my health. Both the Johnson & Johnson and Pfizer vaccines have far exceeded the efficacy threshold set down by regulating authorities, and at the end of the day, that's what really matters. Most of the differences between vaccines come down to the nitty-gritty of how they are made and how they're stored, neither of which have any impact on you or I. Both vaccines teach your body to identify the enemy and build up immunity to it. the Pfizer vaccine uses messenger RNA, a technology that delivers the virus's genetic code to cells, which provides them with a recipe of how to develop antibodies and other immunity weapons to fight it. This kind of technology is pretty fragile, so to remain effective and stable, the Pfizer vaccine must be stored at sub-zero temperatures, which means your fridge wouldn't be of much help here. So what impact does a Pfizer jab being included into the vaccine mix have on you and I? The only impact is when it comes to dosage. The Johnson & Johnson is a single dose vaccine. The Pfizer is a two jab vaccine. An initial priming dose followed by a booster shot with an interval of 21 days. That's it, simply a difference in dose. So, which is the best vaccine to get? That's easy, the one that's offered to you. The efficacy rates for both vaccines are high and side effects equally minimal. And remember, side effects do not signal that the vaccine is unsafe, not working, or a bad choice. They're a sign of an immune system kicking into gear.